Hello friends, I am Balaji Rao. Welcome to BR Max class. In this class, we will learn how to find inverse of a matrix by using elementary transformations. First, I'll consider given matrix as A. I considered given matrix as A. Now, I need to find A inverse. How? By using elementary transformations. We have some standard procedure to find inverse of given matrix by using elementary transformations. In that, first step is I'll consider A equal to IA. This is the fixed step for every problem of this type. We know that IA equal to AI equal to A. This is the property which always holds good. So I can consider like this. Now what I'll do, in place of this A, I'll write the matrix A. See, in place of A, I written this matrix A. Now, what is I? I means identity matrix. So, in place of I, I'll write identity matrix. We know identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 1. And here important thing is, this A we will write as it is. In place of this A, we don't write matrix A. Okay? So, first you consider given matrix as A. Afterwards, you write A equal to IA. And in place of A, you write matrix A. In place of I, you write identity matrix. A, you keep it as it is. From now onwards, what I'll explain, you please follow the things as it is to get the answer easily. It is not compulsory. You should follow what method I am saying to get the answer. In different methods also, you may get the answer. But if you follow the method what I am saying, then you will get the answer easily. Okay. Now, what is my intention? You observe this matrix. I want to convert this matrix into identity matrix by using U rule. You know identity matrix means 1, 0, 0, 1. This is the identity matrix. What I am saying here, I want to convert this matrix into identity matrix by using U rule. U rule means first I'll make this element 1. Please observe here. I'll make this element 1. Later, I'll come to this. I'll make this element 0. I do not go for this element. Try to understand. U rule. First, I'll make first element 1. Immediately below element, I'll make 0. After that, I'll come here and I'll make this element 1. And then I'll come here, I'll make this element 0. This you will understand in the procedure. What I am trying to do? I am trying to convert this matrix into identity matrix by using U rule. Okay, you observe here. What is this? In this place, here 1 is there. But here, 1 is not there. What I am trying? I am trying to convert this matrix into identity matrix. In identity matrix, first element must be 1. But here, 1 is not there. So, you should make this element 1. How? To make any element 1, particularly in this model, you just multiply complete row with 1 by 2. Or just divide with 2. You observe this. This is the element I want to convert into 1. This is in which row? This is in first row. So, I'll write like this. First row, R1. How R1 changes? I want to make this element 1. How I can make this element 1? I'll divide this complete row with 2. Which is nothing but I'll multiply row 1 with 1 by 2. Suppose here 3 is there. You need to make this into 1. You just multiply with 1 by 3. No other thing. You can make in another methods also. But if you follow this procedure, you will get the things very easily. Okay. Now what I'll do? I'll apply this elementary operation. All the elements of first row, I'll multiply with 1 by 2. Okay, you observe this is the first row, na? You multiply 1 by 2 into 2. 1 by 2 into 2 is what? 1. Okay, now 1 by 2 into 1. 1 by 2 into 1 is 1 by 2. Okay, first row equal to. Here the thing is, this operation is applicable for this matrix also, for the first row. Okay, 1 by 2 into 1. 1 by 2 into 1 is 1 by 2. Okay, next, 1 by 2 into 0. 1 by 2 into 0 is 0. I hope you are understanding. Is there any change in row 2? No, there is no change in row 2. So, I'll write row 2 as usual. 1, 1, 0, 1 into A. Okay, good. Now, please observe. What is my intention? I want to convert this into identity matrix. In that procedure, I am making this element 1. You observe here, I got 1 here. Okay. Now, immediately, as per U rule, you come here. Don't go for this element. You come here. What element is there here? Here 0 is there. So what I want? I want 0 here. In this place, I want 0. How I'll get 0 here? Very simple. When 1 is there here, making this element 0 is dead easy. See here, I want to make this element 0. 1 minus 1. It's simple. So what I'll do? I want to convert this element into 0. This element is in which row? This element is in second row. So R2. R2 changes to. What row you written here, immediately you write the same thing. Here you written R2 means you don't get R3, R1 here. What you written here, write the same thing. R2. 1 minus 1. Minus. This 1 is in first row. R2 minus R1. Writing this operation is very easy. Little bit of practice is needed. That's it. Now, you observe this. Any change in row 1? No. Change is there in row 2 only. So, I'll write row 1 as usual. 1. 1 by 2 equal to row 1 as usual. 1 by 2. 0. Okay. Into A. Now, change is there in R2. How R2 changes? R2 minus R1. 1 minus 1. This is 0. Right? Okay. Now, R2 minus R1. You look here. This is R2. 1 minus 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 is what? 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. Easy simplification only. 0 minus 1 by 2. Look here. R2 minus R1. This second row. R2. 0 minus 1 by 2. 0 minus 1 by 2 is minus 1 by 2. Okay. 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. I hope you are understanding. So, what happening? I am trying to convert this into identity matrix by using U rule. You observe here. What I got here? I got 0. That means this is also over. Now, where to go? You come to this element. This element. You need 1 here. You look here. Here, the element 1 is there? No. You need to make this element 1. How to make this element 1? What operation I am trying to say, you try to understand that and you follow same method for all other problems also. I need 1 here. How I'll get 1? If I multiply with 2. If I multiply with 2, 2 into 1 by 2. 2 will get cancelled, I'll get 1 here. I hope you are understanding. What I'll do, this complete row, I'll multiply with 2. This is in which row? This is in second row. So I'll write like this, R2. R2 changes to. What I want here? I want 1. How I'll get 1 here? If I multiply with 2, 2 into 1 by 2 is 1 only. That's why I'm writing like this, 2 into R2. Okay. Now you see, apply the same operation, what you'll get? This is R2 changes there. Any change in R1? No change in R1. So what I'll do? I'll write 1. 1 by 2. Okay, I'm writing R1 as it is because there is no change in R1. 1 by 2, 0. Okay, into A. Now, is there any change in R2? Yes, all the elements of R2 are multiplied with 2. 2 into 0, that is 0. Okay, now 2 into 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Okay, now 2 into minus 1 by 2. 2 into minus 1 by 2 is minus 1. Okay. Now 2 into 1. 2 into 1 is 2. Okay. Things are going very nicely here. What I am trying for? I am trying to get 1 here. We got 1 here or not? Yes. What I am trying? I am trying to get this matrix as identity matrix. In that process, I am following this U rule. First, I made this element 1. Next, I made this element 0. Next, I made this element 1. Now, you come to this. What I am trying for now? I want to make this element 0. See here, I want to make this element 0. When 1 is there here, making this element 0 is very easy. How? Here 1 by 2 is there. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Here I need 1 by 2. I want to make this element 0. This is in which row? Row 1. So I'll write like this. R1. What operation you written? What row you written? Write the same row. 1 by 2. What element I want here? I want 0 here. To make this element 0, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2 is there, it is easy. So what I'll do, second row, I'll multiply with 1 by 2. Please try to understand. For second row, when I multiply with 1 by 2, 1 by 2 into 1 is 1 by 2, then 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 will become 0. This is easy step only. Little bit of practice is needed. That's it. Why I written this step? Because I want 0 in this place. Right? Okay. Now, any change in R1? Yes, change is there in R1. What is that change? R1 minus 1 by 2 into R2. Okay. R1. R1 means what element here? 1 minus 1 by 2 into R2. R2 means what element is there here? 1 by 2 into 0. So this is 1 minus 1 by 2 into 0 is 0. 1 minus 0 is what? That is 1 only. So this element 1 only. Okay. Now R1. R1 means 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 into the element which is present in R2. What is the element present in R2? That is 1. Okay. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is what? That is 0. It is simple. Almost this problem is over. Okay. That equal to R1 changes to R1. What element is there here? The element 1 by 2 is there. Okay. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 into the element present in R2. What is the element present in R2? That is minus 1. Okay. This is 1 by 2. This minus of minus will become plus. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 2 by 2. That is nothing but 1. So what you will get here? Here you will get 1. Okay. Now R1. What is R1? Here this element. Look here. R1. 0 minus 1 by 2 into corresponding element in second row. That is 2. Okay. So what you are getting here? 0 minus, this 2, 2 will get cancelled. 0 minus 1, that is nothing but minus 1. So you are getting minus 1 here. I hope you are understanding. Right, into A. So any change in row 2? No change in R2. So we will write row 2 as usual. Minus 1. In by what intention we started this problem? I want to make this into identity matrix. You can observe here. I got the identity matrix. To make this matrix into identity matrix, I followed the U rule. That is important. So once you got this is identity matrix, whatever the matrix present here, that is known as inverse of the given matrix. Therefore, 1 minus 1 minus 1 2. I hope you are understanding. So in this way, we can calculate inverse of a given matrix by using elementary transformations. It is all about little bit of practice. Now, I'll do one more problem of same type so that you will get more clarity on these elementary transformations. Okay, you observe the second question. Using elementary transformations, find the inverse of this matrix. I want to find inverse of this matrix. Okay, so first what I did, I considered the given matrix as A. That means I need to calculate A inverse. What is the first step? In all these problems, first step is A equal to IA. What is this? This is the property which is always true. IA equal to A. Now in place of A, you write the given matrix A. What is the given matrix? 1 minus 1, 2, 3 equal to I. I means identity matrix. In place of I, you write identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1 into. Here is the trick. You write this A as it is. Don't write the matrix A. Now, I want to convert this matrix into identity matrix by using U rule. What is U rule? I'll follow this order like, see, first I'll make this element 1. Next, I'll come down and I'll make this element 0. And I'll go here, I'll make this element 1. And I'll go here, I'll make this element 0. That is U rule. Just to remember, I am saying it is U rule. Okay. Okay. Now, first thing, I want 1 at this place. You observe the question. Luckily, here 1 is there. So no need to worry. This step is already over. Feel happy and come down. And you want to make this element 0. You look here, this element is not 0. But when 1 is there here, making this element 0 is very easy. This element is in which row? This element is in second row. Okay, you write R2 changes to what row you written? You write the same row, R2. Here 2 is there. If 2 is present here, 2 minus 2, this will become 0 easily. R2 means the element 2 is there, minus. Here I need 2. How I'll get 2 here? You multiply this number with 2. 2 into 1 is 2. R2. I want to make this element 0. To get 0, 2 minus 2. I need 2 here. So what I'll do? 2 into R1. I hope you are understanding. Right. If I apply this operation, I can make this element 0 very easily. Actually, this is very easy step. Little bit of practice is needed. Okay. Any changes there in R1? You look here, no change in R1. So you write R1 as it is. 1 minus 1, 1, 0 into the matrix A. What I did? I written R1 as it is. Now R2 change is there? Yes, R2 change is there. What is that? R2 minus 2 into R1. You look here, R2, that is 2 minus 2 into R1. What element is there in R1? 1, right? This is nothing but 0. So in this place, you will get 0. Okay, now look this element, R2. R2 means what here? 3. R2, 3 minus 2 times, look here, minus 2 times of R1. R1, what element is there? That element is minus 1. So 3 minus of minus plus, 3 plus 2 is what? 5. So what you will get here? You will get 5. Okay, good. Now, this here also you need to complete R2, you need to apply this operation. R2 is 0 minus 2 times of R1. R1 is what? 1. So what you will get, this is nothing but minus 2. So you write minus 2, right? Now R2 means 1 minus 2 times of R1. R1 is 0. This is nothing but 1. Okay, right. Now you observe, I want to make this element 0. I got 0 here. You observe. So this is done. This is over. Now as per your rule, you come here and you need 1 at this point. You need 1 here, right? How to make this element 1? So many methods are there, but if you follow this method, you will get answer easily. What I'll do to get 1 here, I'll multiply this complete row with 1 by 5. 1 by 5 into 5 is what? That is 1 only. So this is in which row? This is in second row. R2 changes to. What I'll do this complete row, I'll multiply with 1 by 5. 1 by 5 into R2. Now, any changes there in R1? No change in R1. So what you will do? You write R1 as it is. R1 as it is. 1, 0 into A. Any changes there in R2? Yes. What is the change? All the elements of second row multiply with 1 by 5. 1 by 5 into 0, that is 0. 1 by 5 into 5, that is 1. Okay. 1 by 5 into minus 2. 1 by 5 into minus 2, that is minus 2 divided by 5. All the elements of second row you multiply with 1 by 5. 1 by 5 into 1, that is 1 by 5. Okay, almost over. See here, I want at this place 1. I got 1 here. What I am trying for? I am trying to make this matrix into identity matrix. In that procedure, I am using this U rule. Here I got 1. This 0 is also over. 1 is also over. Now what I need here? I need 0 at this place. Look here, come here. I want in this place 0. Okay, how I'll get 0 in this place? When 1 is there here, making this 0 is very easy. Here minus 1 is there, you add with this element. Minus 1 plus 1 is what? 0 now. So what I'll do, I want to make this element 0. This is in which row? This is in first row. R1 changes to R1 plus R2. I hope you are understanding. This is easy only. Little bit of practice is needed. That's it. Okay. Any change in R1 is there? Yes. Change in R1 is there. We are adding R1 and R2. Okay. 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. Minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. Okay. That equal to. In this also. Here also. You add 1 R1 plus R2 na. Here R1 means what is there? 1 plus R2 means what is there? Minus 2 by 5. See, plus of minus is minus. This is what? 5 minus 2. That is 3 by 5. Okay. So what you are getting here? You are getting 3 by 5. Okay. Now, this one. R1 plus R2. R1 plus 0 is there. Plus R2 plus 1 by 5 is there. 0 plus 1 by 5 is 1 by 5. So you got 1 by 5 here. Okay. Into A. Now R2 elements as usual. 0, 1, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. So you observe here, we got the identity matrix. Once we got identity matrix here, the problem is over. Whatever the matrix is present here, that is inverse of the given matrix. So what is the conclusion? Therefore, I can write A inverse. What is A inverse? A inverse is 3 by 5, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. I hope you understand this class. If you want me to do one more video on this finding inverse by using elementary transformations, please comment below. And guys, if you like this video, please drop a like and share this video with your friends. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.